In this place where Ellen White spent the last 15 years of her life, she found a home that suited her perfectly. Here in this house, she had a place where she could read, write, pursue her hobbies, and spend time with her family who lived nearby. We see the contrasting side of Ellen White during her time in this house. We see her as a grandmother, taking time to spend with her grandchildren and be involved in their lives. We also know that in this house, the angels of God came to minister to her, and she heard the voice of God speaking. On one occasion, she reported an extraordinary experience that happened on the night of the 2nd of March, 1907, here in this very room. The room was full of light. She awoke to see a bright cloud, white as snow, with the edges tinged in deep pink. Angels sang for her, and she heard a voice that said, "Fear not, I am your savior. Holy angels are all about you." She wondered if she was in heaven and if her work on earth was done. She inquired, "Is this indeed heaven? Am I one of God's little children? And shall I always have this peace?" The voice replied, "Your work is not yet done." According to Ellen White, her sleep here was often broken, a little after midnight and sometimes before, as the Lord spoke to her in visions while her mind was free from cares and surrounding influences. Seldom did she stay in bed after a vision. She usually dressed and, with kerosene lamp in hand, walked down this hallway to her writing room to record what the Lord had shown her. Here in this spot, Ellen White would write her letters and books, a work that would have worldwide influence. Under the impression of the Holy Spirit, she would convey the messages that had been revealed to her. However, Ellen White never forgot her human side and was ever mindful that she had grandchildren who lived nearby who liked nothing more than to see their grandmother. Ellen White had an assistant named Sarah McIntyre, who was particularly vigilant in ensuring that she wasn't disturbed when she was writing. If you didn't have an appointment, then you couldn't see her, even if you were a grandchild. She would often tell the grandkids, "Run along, run along." The grandkids, however, soon worked out that there was a back door that they could sneak in, and they could come up this back staircase right here. They knew that their grandmother's work was important, but they wanted to see her, and so she worked out a sign for them. If she was holding her pen in her hand and writing, then they had to wait at the door. But once she laid her pen down, then they could run across and see her. She would often tell them in these short but precious moments, "Remember that your name is White. You must always keep it that way. And there is a heaven to win and a hell to shun." These visits would only last maybe 2 to 3 minutes, and then they would quietly sneak back down the stairs and out the back door. The kids were happy, Grandma was happy, and Sarah was happy because she didn't know what had happened. While she was the messenger of God and took this role very seriously from the age of 17 until her death, she was also an attentive, loving, and caring grandmother, able to blend family life and ministry together. It's not always an easy balance to achieve, and something that many of us struggle with. May we not excel in one to the detriment of the other, but may we be able to find harmony between these two areas in our lives.